God is healing cancer tonight in a very simple manner. Give him a big hand. Somebody's leg just grew now. Somebody's short leg just grew. Somebody's short leg just grew. Yes. God is so humorous.
Pastor.
Yes.
This lady is a nurse. She said for 13 months, she suddenly developed pain around the scapular bone. That is directly behind the chest. For that reason, she could not carry out her nursing duties properly. She said even her friends has been helping her at the nurse station. She said today, as she placed her hand at the affected part, the pain suddenly left her.
Young lady, do what you couldn't do for 1 year plus. You couldn't do that?
I couldn't.
You couldn't do it?
Yes.
It was painful.
Very painful. Inside, right inside the scapula for 13 months now.
For how many months?
13 months.
For
it started
13
last year, June, yes.
Now, no pain?
No pain.
No pain?
No pain.
Ooh. You are clapping for Jesus. You ain't clapping for the kingdom. Yes.
Pastor, 7 years ago, this young man sat by a loudspeaker. And after that, he could no longer hear with his left ear. It is something called noise-induced hearing loss. But in this service, noise-induced hearing loss was shattered. He can hear very well now with the left
ear. You can hear with the left ear?
Yes, sir.
You can hear clearly?
Yes, sir.
Will you give... Are you... You know... Excuse me? You know what? This is the simplest healing we have ever heard. No stress... No shouting, just obeying instruction. Obey what? I just obeyed instruction, that's all I'm doing. And it's healing the whole people. And the healings are not conventional healings, they are uncommon miracles. Special miracles. Nobody shouted here, nobody screamed here, nobody vibrated here. My friend, give him the hand. Hallelujah. Everywhere, people are just coming out miracles. How can cancer go? Cancer, vanish. Not one people with cancer. That's something you scream and shout and say, in Jesus' name, I bind you cancer. I cast you cancer. And then somebody just say, Holy Spirit, and then the cancer leaves. I did nothing. You did nothing. We're only watching him do all the things. God is good. Glory to God. I strongly believe that someone should be sensitive enough from the healings to catch the other ones. That the healing that took place, the same way the same way he has given you mind to create wealth. If after tonight you look for a job, you are the most stupid person on this earth. If after tonight you are still asking, you know, you didn't know even the service you came to. It's a night where Holy Ghost is just doing certain things. That already you were a candidate for. I was missing, said, stop. I'm the one that creates wealth. And I followed this instruction. And I followed the instruction for healing. Your testimony for healing. So the testimony for wealth will come very soon. Because wealth is not something that comes immediately like healing. Healing is instant. What has happened now, you have to use the mind to create the wealth. So you hear someone say, well, last month, I was looking for a job, but do you know the idea God gave to me? I already have 100 people working for me. I said, well, I have 1,000 people working for me. I have 2,000 people working for me. And 1 year, this time next year, he said, last year, this time I was looking for a job, but I have 2,600 people working for me. And my account has moved from 6 figures to 9, 10, 11 figures. Are you getting what I'm talking about? You will hear very humbling testimonies from today's meeting. I don't see anybody here looking for a job. If you look for a job after today, this will make you jump. Because the Holy Spirit has created some strange things on your inner mind for world creation. How can you be a world creator and be looking for transfer money after now? Yes, sir. Let's take and so we can.
Pastor.
Yes.
This young man for 3 months has been suffering itching and penile discharge. Said he's usually purulent. As he placed his hand on the affected side, after he went to the restroom, he checked himself, he's all dried up. Give he got
Jesus
his healing.
A big hand. Yes.
Papa.
Yes, doctor.
Papa, he gave a word of knowledge about toothache that got healed. Three of them, they all had severe toothache. Both for 2 years and his for 1 week. He even had a hole that was supposed to be filled by surgery. But while he gave the word of knowledge, they all got healed. The tooth hole miraculously got filled up.
The hole got filled up. You are giving Jesus a big hand, young bird. How you doing? Give Jesus a big hand up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God bless all of you. Amen.
Pastor.
Yes.
Two in one testimony here. She came with chest pain and peptic ulcer pain with blurring of vision. She said as we were ministering, the peptic ulcer that has lasted for over 16 years has suddenly left her. She can now see clearly. All has been left.
Everything gone. You give Jesus a big hand. Glory to God. God is so good. People are waiting for Sunday when God is working on Thursday. They are going to say, well, I'll wait till the last day. They're going to not work like that. They can work anytime. It's humbling every one of us, including me. We are all humble. So don't think I got. And one thing with God is that we don't humble you. Everybody, some people are waiting, you know, I'll come the last day. And some even left in between. God is not like that. God, I'm a sensitive person to the Holy Spirit. When he wants to give instruction, I leave all my ideas. I leave all my feelings and allow him. Ooh, grace. Yes, doctor.
Pastor, she came here with severe abdominal pain. After surgery last year, June, she had a surgery. And after the surgery, she developed
She's present at tummy, no pain?
Yes, sir. No she pain. Had cesarean section. And she had something like peritonitis after the surgery. That's inflammation of the covering of the abdominal wall, abdominal cavity. And since then, she has been having severe pain. And each time she touches the abdomen, she has severe pain. But when you mention that whoever has pain anywhere, she place her hand. She place her hand on the abdomen, and after that, the pain completely
disappears. Lady, no pain. No pain. Give her the microphone. No pain.
Yes, sir.
No pain. She's been touching her tummy. She's no pain. Give Jesus a big hand. You ain't clapping for Jesus. You ain't clapping for him. We clap for him. Do better for him. Do better for him. Give him a big hand. Give him a big hand. What a mighty God we serve.
Pastor.
Yes, doctor.
Both of them came with severe migraine headache. She said her own has lasted for 3 days. But the power of God touched her today. Her migraine headache disappeared. She said whenever she's stressed, this young lady, she's a Bible school student. In her own understanding, she said she expected to be having the headache today because it comes with stress. But to her own understanding, the headache suddenly left her. She has been healed.
Will you give Jesus a big hand? You are clapping for him. Are you clapping for him? Clap for him. Hallelujah.
Pastor.
Doctor.
I'm just coming from the restroom with this young man.
Yes, holy.
Said he has been having right inguinal hernia. It comes out. He said when it comes out, he pushes it in, it goes back. But when he stands up, the thing comes out again. But pastor, in this service, he said he felt something touch him. And he wanted to confirm whether the thing was still there. So he came here. I followed him to the restroom. We checked. I asked him to elicit some of the things we do for it to come out. He had to cough. It wasn't there. He did it repeatedly. He did it hardly. We couldn't see it. It has vanished.
Will you give
it has disappeared. He's here.
Give Jesus a shout of praise. Let's press him. Oh, in the name of Jesus. To me before I teach. He said to me, I'm the spirit of judgment. I'm the one that heals. I'm the one that creates wealth. I'm the one that judges. How many want him to judge? Say, Holy Spirit,
Holy Spirit,
I agree with your son,
that
everyone
behind kidnapping
and the kidnappers
in Nigeria
and anywhere we are all connected, beginning with Riverside. Those of you watching in Bayelsa, say beginning with Bayelsa, those Lagos, we call it the state name, we decree.
By your power of judgment,
let those behind the evil of armed robbery, kidnapping, not see this time next week. We command from the rulers to any law enforcement agent behind it, to the boys, to the girls, we declare, spirit of judgment, execute your judgment upon them now, in Jesus' name. Watch what will happen. Watch what will. They'll be dying like rats, one after the other. They will die like what? They will just be dying one after the other. That's a strange move of the spirit. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You just hear, beginning from this night. I have never seen him move like this. He is so sweet. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Yes, doctor?
Pastor, for 3 months, she says she has had, for 1 week, she has had severe migraine headache that comes with eye pain. She cannot even look at the light whenever the pain comes with body weakness. She said as you were ministering, she regained herself, she got her health, and right here she has been healed.
Will you give Jesus praise? We give him praise, yes.
Pastor?
Yes.
This woman came to church. According to her, she was on admission last week. She was sick. And she came to church frail and feeble, no strength. But right in the service, as ministration went on, she got supernatural strength, unexplainable vigor, and right now she has regained her strength.
Will you give Jesus?
Pastor.
Also, Mama came in with abdominal pain. According to her, it has been very tender. She has not been able to open bowel. Then, while you were ministering, she said she doesn't understand English, but while you were ministering, she heard touch where it's hot here. She just touched it. All of a sudden, the pain disappeared.
In the world, God does not need to work with you understanding English. Mama does not understand English yet. He healed her.
Yes. She's surprised that just like
Mama,
that.
But which language does Mama speak? Which way is Sabi speak?
No.
Which way they talk? Igbo, Igwele?
Igbo.
Ah. Chineke Gozie. God has healed her. So tell her in Igbo. Chineke. God has healed her. We thank God. Chineke Mama. Thank you, Jesus. Give Jesus a big hand. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. God has been so good for everything. This one is at the headquarters. We are not thinking satellite churches. Too much that I've done. Look at the one he did for you. Is that true?
God is with. Blessed be the Lord.
Just take one or two. Let's go to God's word. Why do we heal it that he just continues? Yes, take.
Papa.
Yes.
They all got healed of pain in various parts of their body. 2 months ago, he was playing football and someone stepped on his chest with the football boot. Since then, he has been able to bend without pain or touch his back. While we are mentioning the power of God touched him, he's totally healed. They all got healed of pain in various parts of their body.
Hey, give Jesus a big hand. Yes, doctor.
Pastor.
Yes.
He came here with severe febrile illness. When the ministration was going on, the entire fever disappeared. He's made whole completely. Hallelujah. She came here with severe backache with rashes. Then she traveled to village last year for Easter. And before she came back, she noticed that the rashes appeared on her waist area. Since then, she had been having severe pain. But right here, both the rashes have disappeared and the pain.
Lady, where are you from? Where are you from?
I'm from Enugu.
From Enugu?
Yes.
So wherever is behind the rashes, I command you to go back to the center.
Amen.
As you are healed, that evil goes to where it came from. In Jesus' name. You have the spirit of judgment. We can't only judge armed robbers. We can't judge only kidnappers. Lift your right hand as the Holy Spirit. I'm flowing by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Say, Holy Spirit, I agree with your son. You are the spirit of judgment. Every evil in my life, judge right now. Now declare something. Declare something. Every evil in my business, every evil in this ministry, judge them. Judge every evil by your spirit. Judge whoever is behind any attack on my life, on my family, on Salvation Ministries planning to attack us, judge them. Anyone planning to attack Salvation Ministries, judge them. Anyone planning to attack the Ibiyeomie, judge them. Anyone planning to attack any Jenny member, judge them. Anyone planning to attack any Jenny visitor, judge them. Judge them. Judge them. Judge them. Judge them. Judge them. In Jesus' name. Say, I agree with your son. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit. Every evil against Salvation Ministries, against genuine members, genuine visitors, ministries that have come for this program, against online worshipers, right now, judge them. Judge them. Anyone planning to attack David Ibiyeomie, his family, planning to attack Salvation Ministries, judge them before they attack. By your spirit, execute judgment. Judgment. Anyone planning to attack me or have attacked me, judge them. Judge them. Judge them. Judge Satan and his agents right now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Woo! For all that God has done. For everything that happens so simple. For all that Lord has done, I will sing hallelujah.
We will sing hallelujah.
Thank you with
sing
the song.
Hallelujah. Come to the
lift your voices and tell him thank you. Lord, we appreciate you. We thank you, mighty God, for all that you have done. We celebrate you. We adore you. We magnify your name for all that you have done. We say thank you. We say thank you. We say thank you. Blessed be your name. And Jesus' most wonderful name. Amen. To him alone we give all the glory.